Take two. Okay? Alright. The student depends on what teacher shows up.
Wait, write that.
The student depends on what teacher shows up.
That's the first point.
I'm gonna tell you the title. Okay, I'm gonna go off on a tangent. So if you don't hear me, wait for the recording. Okay, because I'm gonna go on a tangent. This is gonna be less educational and more just me just raising belief and just pouring into some of y'all. So just make sure y'all open up y'all's ears and y'all's hearts. Okay. So right, the student depends on the teacher that shows up. Okay. People always used to tell me in the business, the best thing you can do for Richard, the best thing you can do for your upline is what?
Show up.
Show up and?
Show out.
Show out. And showing out gives you?
Grow.
We were always taught that. Show up, show out, grow. Can we agree that might be the best thing to do for your upline? Okay, I disagree. Okay, I was taught the exact same line. The best thing you can do, the best thing Carlos can do for Abby is do everything he can, build a team, be successful, get Abby to mastermind. Get Abby to level two. The best thing Jen can do for Miriam is get promoted, hire someone, and get her to level two. The best thing Nia can do is just learn the business, right? Get her qualifying days and go get qualified. Okay? Can we agree? That's what normally most people would think is the best thing to do for their upline. But imagine if they grow out of alignment. Imagine if they don't know their upline's goals. Do you think their team does? Right? Growing out of alignment with your upline is the most divisive thing you can ever do for the culture. Right? Growing and not sitting down with your upline and knowing their goals. Right? If Sharon's going to grow a big team because of his personality, because of his charisma, and because of his leadership, and because he hits the field so hard, and he's always excited, and communicates a lot, if he grew, it would be the best thing for the business. If he grew out of alignment with where 5G wants to go, it'd be the worst thing for the business. Because he's going to be a huge impact on the business no matter what. He's going to be a huge thing on the business no matter what. And so, if Sharon's not in alignment with me, if me and him aren't constantly on the same page, it's bad for business. Everyone see where I'm going with this? Mm-hmm. Okay, our leaders, right? It's the reason why I have a one-on-one with Miriam and Abby every week. It's the reason why I want to get to know Jen. Because I want her to talk about my goals as well. I want to talk about Richard's goals all the time. Right, because everything in this business, everything in this office, from the TVs to the floor to the dirty stain over the carpet that pisses me off, okay, is all because of Richard. I am a walking principle of Richard's culture. I am a product of my belief, which is God, and Richard. And so it is my duty, it is my obligation to grow in alignment with him. Agree? Whether you are on okay terms, best friends, or just acquaintances with your upline, they hired me. They told me, hire this person, Danny. Hire this person, Alexis, please, because they are good for business. They told us that. They determined if you got the position. So whether they're right or wrong, they were right enough to bring you on board. And so we should use that to measure our level of gratitude, because I use it to measure Richard. Richard had no incentive to take me under his wing and mentor me when I moved to Dallas. Had no incentive whatsoever. He did not know if I was going to be an owner. He did not know if I was going to be successful. Okay, I'm telling you, bro, my outfit to orientation for Chang was Sperry's. Sperry's, bro. No socks. Sperry's. Already there, it's downhill. There's no other way that you can. I've never seen someone make Sperry's look good. Who wears Sperry's in here? I was just kidding, y'all make it look great, okay? I can't make it work. Okay? And then oh my god, jeans that I cuffed myself. You ever cuff jeans by yourself? Okay, they're bad, okay? It's like, oh my god. Anyways, right? And then a white plain t-shirt. And then a cardigan over it. A cardigan. I got hired in May. In Texas. Was that the recipe for someone who's gonna be a business owner? Yeah. Hell no. No. But when I saw Richard's principles, when I saw Chang's standards, when I saw what the business could be, I never wanted to be the reason why someone doubted the opportunity. So I fixed my act, I fixed my language, I fixed my morals, I fixed my ethics, and I got in alignment with Richard's goals. Because I wanted to be the reason why Richard gets retired. I wanted to be the sole reason why his kid walks in health. I wanted to do that. I take pride in that. And you should think that too, right? The next thing is the student determines the teacher that shows up. You should never want to be the reason why somebody doubts the opportunity. I never wanted to be the reason why someone doubted the opportunity. Feel free to take notes. I never want to be the reason why someone doubted if they could do this. Now, am I saying that with anything? The number one rule is most people think, hey, show up, show out, and grow. That's what we're told was the best thing to do for our upline. I disagree, okay? And I'm here to tell you, you should too. This is why the best thing to do for your upline is to be edifiable. The number one thing to do for your upline is be edifiable. Now, let's talk about edification. What is edification? Carlos, tell me what edification is, really quick. Do you know what the word edify means? No? Cool. Open your ears and open your heart today. We're gonna pour into you. Okay, who wants to know what edification means? Raise your hand before you. No. Love y'all. Cash. This just stick. Go ahead. Someone. It's fine. It's all right. Edification. What do you think it means to you?
Be able to learn, change.
Okay. So, being open to change, okay? What is, now leader, tell me what edification means.
Edification, like, is really someone else being able to say, like, speak on the actions that you do, and when no one's looking, especially. Like, letting your actions speak.
Letting your actions speak, that's great. Okay, what else did you want to say?
Being edifiable just means hoping to be edified, just means to be like acknowledged for the work that you're doing.
Mm-hmm. The right thing.
Acknowledgement, right? Can we agree? Edification is really just acknowledgement in a positive manner. Okay, edification, what I wrote is gratitude in action.
Gratitude and action.
Gratitude in action. That's what I think being edifiable means. Right? Edification is gratitude in action. Right? If I want to edify Richard, who's never met Richard in person? Who thinks he's a good mentor? Who thinks he's a bad mentor? Leave your hand up. But y'all never met him. Right? Who knows how old Richard is?
32.
Close.
27.
20. 20. 28. He's 28. His birthday just came by. He's 28 and has over 7 that he makes into the 7 figures now. Between all of his organization, write the statistic down. Between Rich's organization, he is mentoring in total $10 million in business. He is the reason why there is people that can run businesses that are worth $10 million put together. Between all of his owners saved up, not including him, between all of his owners saved up, there's over $600,000 in savings. Including me, including Alexis, including Cassandra and Charlotte, including Tracy and Alante in Hollywood, okay? Including Aaron in San Diego, California, including Steven in California, right? He has mentorship in different time zones. Have you ever thought about that? He's in Dallas, and he mentors people on either coast. He's been in this industry for 3 years. less than almost 1,000 days. Isn't that insane? I wanted to be a part of that. You should too. And you should do it, not in your words, but in your actions. Right? Our actions should always be in alignment with how grateful we are for this opportunity. I have not seen another business like this industry. I've not seen one that is giving me the fruit of the labor that I put in. But you reap what you sow in this business. Who here before this could have thought that someone your age could be in the position of we talk about putting people on people's payrolls in this business. And we make it seem like it's something so nonchalant now. Put my parents on my payroll type of team. Imagine you saying that at Chick-fil-A when you're laying down the fries and the grease. Pay my parents weekly type of team. The person flipping the chicken would be like, what the hell are you talking about? Hourly type of team. Okay? Right? Like, think about it. Your mindset has already changed just from this association. Wouldn't it only be right to move in alignment with your upline? Doesn't it make almost zero sense to keep growing and not know what the hell your upline's goals are? Isn't it almost like, whoa, that sounds kind of dumb now? When's the last time we sat down and heard our upline's goals? What is our upline's why? Right? What is our main goal in the business? That's the reason why I have my goals up there. Okay? That's the reason why I make sure to talk about my goals every single day. Because I want to make sure the person Sebi hires, they know my goals. Because if they're not with the morals and alignments with what Richard instilled in me, I don't want them as part of the culture. I'm so glad that my morals, Alexis's morals, attracted somebody like you. Attracted somebody like Miriam. And make them stay through the adversity, through the hardship. That someone as shy as Jen is more attracted to the culture and what she knows this could be. And she's like, I'm willing to put myself outside of my comfort zone because I know what this office stands for. Every day you show up, you become edified. Right? But it's the edification and what we do with that day that helps us. You ready for it? Okay, here's another quote for y'all. If you're not moving in gratitude, you're living in entitlement. If we are not moving in gratitude, we are living in entitlement. That sounds a little harsh. I 100% agree. If you do not move in every action with your upline's goals in mind, then you are stagnant in entitlement. If we do not move in gratitude, we live in entitlement. Right? My number one goal was I wanted to be edifiable without disclaimers. Without disclaimers. What's a disclaimer? A warning. Hey, XYZ leader is really, really good at on the field, but it's not compliant all the time, so be careful. Hey, this person's really, really good at relationship building, but they don't build the right relationships, so watch out. Hey, Danny can drive sales in the business, but he can't retain leaders. I never wanted to be that. You shouldn't too. Hey, you're a great leader, but you don't show up all the time. Hey, you have great energy, but you're a sucky student. Hey, you got a qualifying day, but you haven't talked about your systems. Hey, I think you can make it with this business, but I don't know yet because you haven't dove in deep. Thanks so much. You shouldn't want to hear a but at the end of your edification. That's a disclaimer. Right, what do you want to be edified with without no disclaimers? Right, take a couple seconds. What do you want your upline to give you a shout out today? Right, who wakes up and is like, I hope someone shouts me out? Does anybody think like that? Y'all are way better than me because I used to think like that. I'm like, I hope Richard shouts me out. Hands down. My love language is words of affirmation. I have no problem saying that. The thing is, I used it to power my motivation. I said, hey, I I want to be edified every single day. I don't need it, but I want it. So you know what I did? Every single time I was in the office, every single time I was on the field, every single chance I had to be the best leg for Richard in the business, I did. Because everything I did was like, I hope Richard shouts me out. I hope me doing this makes Richard think of like, damn, he deserves a shout. So reality, is it bad to want a shout out?
No.
If anything, it's the intention behind it. I made sure my actions were in alignment with my upline. That way it could. Does anybody act like that in the field? I used to be like, hey, I'm a high roll today because I want to get a shot. I'm going to go out to the field today and I'm gonna get qualified, right? Like, who here high rolls and like, I can't wait to do weather. Anybody like that? I used to think like that too. That's okay. That's 100% okay. It's 100% okay to be like, high roll the nation. Sharon's like, Danny, how do you feel being the number one selling the nation? I'm like, bro, that's pretty cool. To be the first one in an entire division across 50 states, and he was the first sale. I take pride in that. Because I know he's like me. Sharon's like me. I'm calling Carlos and I'm like, bro, do not leave without a qualifying day. Don't come back unless you have a qualifying day. Right, he walked in, but he walked in early. With some swag. He walked in and did a little walk. And isn't it funny? Right? When somebody does really, really good, are they more likely to come in early?
Yes.
Are they more likely to teach back their systems?
Yeah.
It's because it feels good to be recognized. It feels good to be acknowledged. Be acknowledged for the right things. Be talked about in the right way. Be talked about with no gossip behind it. Be edified without any disclaimers. Right, so now the next, so that's what edification is. That's what being edifiable means. Now, how to do that as a leader, how to do that as somebody in this business. Number one thing you have to understand, this is the concept, okay? Right, is people duplicate. What you do, not what you say. People duplicate what you do, not what you say. Hey Danny, can you have this conversation about this person that like there's this negative trend we've been going around of, and it's so funny because I didn't know and I've been negligent in my business, so I apologize, right? But for the people, I'm also gonna leave this, I'm like, hey, right? How many of y'all would eat a nice big steak at, what was the steak place around here? Capital Grill? Y'all know Capital Grill? Cool, let's say Capital Grill. Get a nice $89 steak. I know the exact price, okay? Medium rare. Just bloody, like it still moves. Right, and you eat it and you're full. Can we agree most people would be full after that? Who wouldn't be full? Okay, so you get another side. Let's say you get another side. Right, you get your mashed potatoes, because you don't eat meat. That's why you said it. Okay, right? You eat a good hearty meal. Whatever your dream meal is, think about it. It's sitting right in front of you, mama's home cooked meal, okay? Or cookout for half of y'all, right? And it's just the best meal ever. And you're sitting there and like you almost have to unbutton your pants because you have to breathe. Yeah. Anybody had that kind of meal?
Yes.
Thanksgiving meal where you're almost like, this belt's too tight now. Okay. How many of y'all on the drive home would pick up McDonald's? Not very many people, right? Because you're not hungry. Because you already accomplished what the goal was, to eat, correct? Okay, we had that negative trend happening, right, for the last couple of weeks, where right after break, where people are used to go to the restroom, get all their snacks, eat, break bread on the same table, right, have fellowship, do whatever they need to do to get ready for the field. We would do car rides, which is to build what?
Momentum
and excitement. And we head straight for pump three at Sheets. Where does momentum go? Through the dirty stain of the carpet. Through the floor. Right, so this is people's emotions. Eating, grub, excitement, and back to sheets. But it doesn't make sense to get McDonald's after your great steak. So it doesn't make sense to go on a break after a break. Okay, if you maximize your time, bro, the field is very temporary. The field is very temporary. Okay, and some of us as leaders, we need to do less conversating and more just getting first to the field, first to make money. I mean that, right? Who's gonna be the first to the field today? Who's gonna send a picture already at the door with a customer? Who's gonna be the first phone? Who's gonna be the first close? Who's gonna be the first sale? I took pride in being the first sale for Dallas every single day I was in the training program. Because I knew I wanted to be the reason why Richard looked the best. I wanted to be the reason why people were visiting Richard's office. It feels good. Right? I wanted to be the reason why Richard, I wanted to be a speaker at a conference because I wanted to get up there and the first word out of my mouth is thank you, God, and thank you, Richard. I'm blessed by this business and in my beliefs. That's the first words I'm going to say when I step on a podium. Hands down. It's because I know I want every chance to edify my mentor because I wanted to move with every chance to be edified. Do you see how that works? Richard looks good, right? Richard's mentorship gets edified, right? And I reap the benefits. It's a very, very win-win scenario. But in order to, before I could get the mouth of edification, before I could get the affirmation, I had to make sure I was the first on the board, I was the last one to leave the field, I was the first one in for leaders meetings, I never missed a singles leaders meeting. You should think like that too. We should think like that too. Don't miss a single meeting. Don't be late. Don't be the person that shows up at 11:44 and just becomes a salesman for the day because you don't have time to teach back systems and get through the business. There's four steps to learning the business, right? Learn the sales, teach the sales, learn payroll.
Get out.
Learn the sales, teach the sales, learn payroll, pick a city. That's the business. The people who make it complicated are humans. And I know because I made it complicated. I was a reason looking for a way out rather than a reason to buy in. And so my team saw that because people duplicate what you do, not what you say. So I can go out there today and be like, hey, if you hit 100 doors, you'll be successful. If you get 50 people to open the door, you'll be successful. If you hire 10 people, you will build a leader. I can tell you that, or you can do it and see it for yourself. Agree? Two. I know it, but I want to write it the exact same way. Okay, people are attracted to morals and ethics, not production. Not what?
Production.
So if you have seven emojis on the board, are you the biggest, baddest person entering the room the next day?
No.
Right? Now, but hear what I just said. I wanted to hire the office so I could get a shout out from Richard. But that didn't mean when I came in, I would go to all the zeros and be like, yo, I whooped your ass. I wasn't coming in saying, hey, I sold around you. I wasn't that person full reading my press clippings. You should not want to ever read your press clippings. Does anyone know what press clippings are? Okay, they're your highlights. Okay, do you think LeBron James Googles LeBron James highlights? Do you think Kobe Bryant, when he was living in hell, okay, rest in peace, okay, do you think he was looking at his highlights? No, right, the best, what were they doing?
Learning how to get better.
They were perfecting their craft. They were watching film. They were watching film. They were looking more for their flaws than their achievements. Isn't that crazy? Imagine someone who was edified throughout the entire nation, the world, known across all continents. Arguably in talks with Michael Jordan of the best basketball player that ever lived. And you know what Kobe's response was? If there was no Michael Jordan, there would never be me. He says that. He says, don't ever put me in that conversation, because if there's no Michael Jordan, I can never do anything. Because all Kobe Bryant did was copy Michael Jordan. All Kobe Bryant did was copy Michael Jordan. But anybody that was that edifiable, can we agree? If I was as good as Kobe, holy smokes, I would go to the blacktop every morning and just smoke some people. I'd go out there and just talk about, bro, I just put someone on a poster last night. That's why I'm not good at basketball. Because I don't deserve to be that good. Okay? This is what I'm trying to tell you, right? Instead of high-rolling the office and coming back and like, Jenny, look what I did. I did that. Everyone, any of y'all seen Coach Carter?
Yeah.
Anybody seen Coach Carter?
Yeah, I already know.
You know exactly what I'm talking about? Anybody who hasn't seen Coach Carter? Okay, I'm gonna post it in the chat. There's a scene, he's a coach for a basketball team. His name's Carter. and the team gets so good after being so bad, right? They start flaunting the game, dunking on people, getting in their face, getting on them. And so the coach comes back and he ties his shoes and he's like, you like that? I did that. I tied that. And he starts doing it and they're like, Coach, why are you being weird? And he's like, don't disrespect the game that I love. Y'all are tarnishing the image of the game that I fell in love with. When you flaunt about your press clippings, when you read your highlights, when you get stuck in your achievements, when you live in your past accomplishments, when we start to focus on what we do so good in the past, we stop focusing on what we could be doing honestly in the future. We stop caring about the present. I did that. I signed that shoot. I'll post it. It's such a good video. Right? And it's because you your production doesn't define who you are. The same person that rolls a zero is the same person the next day that qualifies. We saw China's potential way before she got her qualifying days. Estelita is not defined on how fast she can get on the board. Now think about that. I just talked about I wanted to get on the board really fast. Not because that's what made me. Because I knew my ethics and my morals would amplify the production, not produce it. Everyone understand that? Okay, I won't dive too deep on that. Last point. People overtask. Now some of you are like, Danny, you just got mad at me for rolling the razor. Okay, yes, you're right, hands down. I'll raise my hand. You're right, but it's because I'm looking at your potential, and no one in this business, every single one of you, I looked at your resume. Right? I looked at your resume and I said, this person is overqualified for the entry-level sales position. Every single one of y'all in this room is too good to go door-to-door. I will say that right now. Every single one of you has the potential to run a business, to coach and mentor 10 to 15 people. Will everyone make it?
Nope.
No. Hands down. Just because you're capable doesn't mean you're going to. Just because you're capable of winning the lottery doesn't mean you're going to. I'm telling you right now, every single one of you is held to your potential. That's why when you go out there and we lower the standards, I'm getting, yeah, hands up. I'm telling you, Genesis, bro, come on, you qualify already, son. Because I know her potential. Not so much focus on production. If you misconstrue these two, okay, and start viewing as your people on numbers, they will turn their back on you and grow divisively and unedify you and de-edify you, and it will be a bad culture on the team. But there is something powerful about when you can sit down on a one-on-one with them and speak into their hearts and get to know their story and get to know their wives and get to know what's made Sevi Sevi and what kind of neighborhood he grew up in New York, okay, and what kind of story Zanaria has and what her dad does in Goldsboro, okay, and what Brianne does and what Brianne's mom did for over 10 years. and what Miriam's sister's names are, okay, and what Angie's little sister's name is, and where Isis's mom lives, okay, and all this stuff. What Sharon's favorite sport is, okay, what China's kids' names are, what Abby's mom does for a living. There's power in knowing that, because I know when I know all of that, when I know Carlos's story, when I know Alexis's struggles, when I know Monza's dog's name, that I can go out there and send you an audio message and get and say, hey, in 30 minutes, get on the board because you deserve it. Because I've done enough one-on-ones with you that I know your heart, I know your potential, I know your standards, and I hold you to your goals and not your attitude for that day. People over tasks, because I know every single one of you, I'm getting to the production that it takes to get out of the day-to-day sales. Me and Alexis hold you to the standard it takes to get you out of the day-to-day sales so you can go and do what you love, which is coaching and mentoring, developing people through your conversations and living the life you deserve because you worked the life that no one wanted to work. Because you went out there and did what nobody else was willing to do, now you can have a fairy tale lifestyle. My family is going to walk in health because I lived below my means for a couple of years. Because I said no to my friends and said yes to my family. I said no to Friday nights and I said yes to 45 years of freedom. You should too. You should go out there and say today and say, I'm gonna get 40 no's so one day I can tell my family yes. I'm gonna get 37 no's today so I can tell fill in the blank yes. Another meeting is that today?
Yes.
Awesome. Cool. So 10:23, okay?